Thanks, Deanna. Really excited to be here and be presenting today. Okay. So actionable strategies to get the most out of Black Friday, Cyber Monday 2022. I am Rachel Tyers, the SVP of Partnerships at Okendo. A little bit about Okendo. Oops, lost my screen there. We're a customer marketing platform that allows brands to connect with their consumers in a meaningful way through tools such as ratings, reviews, surveys, UGC, Q&A, and more. I like to say if you've ever bought anything online, you've probably interacted with Okendo. So we work with over 6,000 fast-growing Shopify brands, including Netflix, Skims, Magic Spoon, and many, many more. Strategy number one, increase Black Friday, Cyber Monday site traffic and paid media return on ad spend. Now, convert followers into subscribers. We know that during Black Friday, Cyber Monday weekend, there's a lot of noise and there is a lot of competition between advertisers trying to get in front of their audience. We make this recommendation to implement audience acquisition surveys. So if you have a significant following on Instagram or maybe TikTok, you can send surveys out to this customer base to collect emails, phone numbers, and zero-party data from them in order to more directly market to them during the busy Black Friday, Cyber Monday period. You can offer coupons or incentives for people to complete those surveys, or it might be a prize entry that they are able to be a part of when they share that information with you. Top tip here as well, always ensure that you have marketing opt-in when you're running these types of surveys. Another strategy that I always recommend is adding star ratings to Google Shopping ads. Now, as you can see here, Skims has added their Okendo star ratings through to their product listings. And from what we know from Google and consumer behavior, these product listings with the star ratings will have a higher click-through and conversion rate than those without. This is very simple to set up as well. In Okendo, it's just a toggle in the back end to turn it on, but a huge improvement in return on ad spend when you implement that. I have a case study here from the office of Angela Scott. They were running their Google Shopping ads. All they did was turn on the star ratings, and there was a 51% decrease in cost per action, an 81% increase in conversion rate, and a 91% increase in return on ad spend. So huge results there. Another great strategy is to utilize reviews and UGC in your paid ads. In my background, performance marketing, some of the ad creative types that I saw have the most success were UGC or user-generated content mashup ads. So this is where you kind of cut together scrappy people talking to the video, overlaid with different sound bites, five-star reviews, these sorts of things. They're short, sharp, not necessarily high production value stuff, but it feels real and authentic. And those often have a really high click-through rate and conversion rate. Another idea is to include reviews within video and image creative. On this example here on the screen, we have Meissen, who actually uses their reviews in a really creative way. They have this one-star review where it says, "I barely even touched the blade and cut myself. You should have put better warnings on your boxes, idiots." So it really shows how sharp their kitchen knives are. You can also use reviews in your ad copy and emojis, 5 stars, 50,000 people agree, those sorts of things. So it really builds that authenticity and social proof. Strategy number two, convert more Black Friday, Cyber Monday shoppers. Now, this is definitely all on our minds. We have this stat from our Loyalty Lion Black Friday, Cyber Monday report. Your shoppers want to act as advocates for your post Black Friday, Cyber Monday. 62% of shoppers are likely to leave reviews this Black Friday. I'm putting that into numbers again. 99.9% of customers will actually read your product reviews before making a purchase. So let's make sure they are built to convert. We love to highlight key selling points with product attributes. In this example from Scotch Porter, you can see as soon as we hit this PDP, we see the scent effectiveness and feel good factor is excellent across the board. So this reduces the reliance of the reviewer putting these key selling points in the body of the review. We also are big proponents of customer attributes. Customer attributes allow your shoppers to align their purchase decisions with other customers that have similar attributes to them. In this example from Ilia Beauty, we have skin type, skin tone, undertone, concern, and age range. So if I'm in that 45 to 54 year old age group and I have a combination skin, my concern is aging, and I see that some I hear loved the product, I'm more likely to have confidence in that decision and more likely to convert as well. Of course, these are all completely customizable based on your product, your brand, no code necessary, inner kendo. And incorporate customer photos. This is a really great tip because 90% of information is transmitted to the brain is visual, and we process images 60,000 times faster than text. It's really nice to include the pictures for authenticity building as well, rather than having those super polished brand images, which we know are important. This allows shoppers to see what the product looks like or may feel like in real life. And then brands can also leverage this UGC across their marketing campaigns. I have an example from Born Primitive, an athletic attire company that we work with. When they implemented those robust reviews with product attributes and customer attributes, they saw a 74.29% increase in UGC generation rate and a 3.3x increase in PDP conversion rate, which is huge. Another area where you can add social proof is into your abandoned cart emails. So you can see we have this aggregate star rating on the Nimble abandoned cart, and we have both a GIF that would slide through the five most recent five-star reviews and an aggregate on the Skims example email on the right. Now, in this Nimble case study, when they added that social proof to their abandoned cart message, they saw a 6% increase in click-through rate and a 16% increase in average revenue per recipient, which is really quite meaningful. And when you're making these incremental improvements on your overall strategy, it goes a really long way. Another idea is to ask for in-moment conversion feedback surveys. So this allows you to get a continuous stream of feedback from people that might have abandoned their cart, and you can discover key conversion drivers or blockers. So people might be planning to buy later, it might be too expensive, maybe they couldn't find exactly what they wanted, or they made a purchase elsewhere. Monitoring these insights and making the appropriate adjustments will improve your strategy overall. And then another tip here is to make real-time adjustments to marketing spend by implementing a post-purchase survey. You can validate your performance marketing with feedback directly from your customers. Where did they hear about you? Was it Facebook? Was it Instagram? Was it TikTok, or from a friend or family member? You can then make real-time adjustments to your budget over the Black Friday Cyber Weekend, and you can maximize marketing spend where it's having the most bang for your buck. Strategy number three, turn Black Friday Cyber Monday shoppers into loyal customers. So monitor customer satisfaction. You can use NPS, CES or CSAT surveys to monitor your customer sentiment. And we believe this should be always on. You should always be monitoring the customer experience and implementing measures to improve that experience overall. Of course, happy customers will turn into brand advocates and come back and purchase from you over and over again. But those customers that might not be so happy will offer a way for you to learn and improve the overall customer experience and drive a high revenue for your brand. Another key strategy here is to personalize campaigns with zero-party data. So you can collect information directly from your customer base via reviews and surveys, then aggregate the data into customer profiles and sync this over to your email service provider, such as Omnisend, Klaviyo, or your SMS platform, such as Attentive, and send targeted personalized messages to those individuals. We know that marketing that's one-to-one has a higher conversion rate, and it speaks directly to that consumer's interests or needs. have an example here from WAG, a dog treats company that we work with. They were collecting information around dog breed, dog age, and eating habits. They then used this info to create segments and send personalized emails out to their user base. And they actually saw a 300% increase in placed order rate and a 423% increase in revenue per recipient, which was huge. And finally, I do have a special offer for the attendees today. Get your first 60 days of Oquendo for free. This covers off both Oquendo Connect, our surveys product, and Oquendo Reviews. You'll just need to sign up before October 31st, request a demo through our website, and mention this webinar to claim the offer. Thank you very much.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Rachel. I love that you can turn a one-star review into a great campaign. That's
right.
That really tickled me. Fantastic. We do have a couple of questions for you. So first of all, what is the best way to add UGC to product images on a website? Facebook makes it easy to add in the shopping section. Any advice for Madison there?
Yeah, that's a really great question. So on your website, you can use what we call media galleries. And so this creates a gallery of UGC across the website. A good example to look at here is if you go to one of the product pages of Ilia Beauty, and they have a really beautiful layout of the products with people using the products, I should say. And then you can hit any of those images to enlarge the UGC. And you can also see the review for that particular image as well. So that's a really nice way to use it. You can leverage that UGC across homepage carousels as well, or perhaps you have a standalone reviews page or media gallery. There's a lot of options there, but leveraging it across various paid media campaigns is also helpful.
Brilliant, thank you. And a question from Zach. As far as product reviews and surveys go, I have lots of clients trying to do this, but conversion is low even with incentives. Do you have any advice for best practice?
Yeah, for sure. So make sure the surveys are loading quickly and make sure that there aren't other apps looking to hit the same spot in the checkout page. You know, I often see, I don't want to name names, but apps that maybe aren't so necessary on the post purchase page that bump down the survey that could be collecting really good results. And so your shoppers actually miss seeing that survey straight away. So really take a look at that post purchase page and see what other apps are vying for the number one spot and make sure you've got a good strategy in place there. Maybe offering a higher coupon or A/B testing the types of coupons is a great idea, and testing various survey types. So you could use on-site surveys, post-purchase, like we've already talked about, or perhaps it's a shareable link in an email or a swipe up from your Facebook or Instagram, I should say.
Perfect. That's great advice. Thank you. And just one more for you. Jennifer is selling products from brands on her site and would like to know, is it a good strategy to use UGC from those brands on her site, even though the customer didn't necessarily buy from her store?
I would make sure I got approval from those brands to use the UGC, because sometimes there are certain rules and regulations that a lot of these bigger brands have in place. Like one of the things that I get asked about all the time is, can I use my reviews and UGC from Amazon on my own website? And I see this app that allows you to import it. Amazon doesn't allow you to do it. So using one of those apps is actually illegal and it could get you banned from the Amazon store. So my advice is always just to check with the brand or with the retailer to make sure you can use that imagery or those reviews, and then go ahead and use it if you're allowed to. But that would be something to look into further with those specific brands.
Fantastic. That is good words of wisdom there. Thank you so much. Brilliant. Well, our prize winner for Oquendo, congratulations to Kate Borsheim, a $50 Forever Mood gift card for some beautiful candles coming your way. Thank you so much, Rachel. Up next, we're handing over to Jay